Hello and welcome to today's video, where we'll be discussing forward, reverse starter circuits for electric motors. If you're someone who's interested in learning how to control the direction of rotation of a motor, then you've come to the right place. A forward, reverse starter circuit is a type of motor control circuit that allows you to start, stop, and reverse the direction of rotation of a motor. It's commonly used in various industrial applications such as conveyor systems, cranes, and hoists. We'll take a look at the components of a forward, reverse starter circuit and how it works. The circuit includes a MCCB, two magnetic contactors, one for forward and one for reverse, an overload relay, a three-phase motor, forward, reverse push buttons, a stop push button, and three indicators, forward, reverse, and trip. Starting with the power circuit, the three-phase line, L1, L2, L3, connects to the MCCB, and the neutral wire connects to the neutral link. The output of the MCCB goes to the first magnetic contactor for forward, and the second contactor is connected in parallel with the first by changing the positions of two phases. The output of both contactors loops T1 of the first contactor with T1 of the second contactor, T2 of the first contactor with T2 of the second contactor, and T3 of the first contactor with T3 of the second contactor. From the reverse contactor, the three-phase supply goes to the motor and connects in the connection box. These cables pass through the electronic overload relay. Moving on to the control circuit, a wire is taken from the output of the MCCB and connected to the MCB. The output of the MCB goes to the A1 coil terminal of the forward magnetic contactor. The same wire is then looped to the A1 terminal of the reverse contactor. From the A1 terminal of the reverse contactor, a light blue wire goes to the L1 terminal of the overload relay, and from there, a wire goes to the forward, reverse, and trip indicators. The neutral wire from the neutral link goes to the L2 terminal of the overload relay and is looped to the 96 terminal of the overload relay, which is the common terminal. In the video, you can see a green wire that connects the 95 normally close terminal of the overload relay to the stop push button. The stop push button has a normally closed terminal that opens when pressed. The wire from the second terminal of the stop push button then connects to the first terminals of the forward and reverse push buttons. These push buttons have normally open contacts that close when pressed. The green wire also goes to the normally open auxiliary contact of the reverse contactor and then loops to the normally open auxiliary contact of the forward contactor. The second normally open auxiliary contact terminal of the forward contactor loops with the A2 terminal of the forward contactor, and the second normally open auxiliary contact of the reverse contactor loops with the A2 terminal of the reverse contactor. Another wire that you can see in the video is an orange wire that connects the second terminal of the forward push button to the normally close auxiliary contact of the reverse contactor. The second normally close auxiliary contact of the reverse contactor connects to the A2 coil terminal of the forward contactor. The same wire loops with the second terminal of the forward indicator. This indicator light will glow if the motor is running in the forward direction. You can also see a dark red wire that goes from the second terminal of the reverse push button to the normally close auxiliary contact of the forward contactor. The second normally close auxiliary contact of the forward contactor loops with the A2 terminal of the reverse contactor. The same wire loops with the reverse indicator lamp. This indicator light will glow if the motor is running in the reverse direction. Finally, a black wire can be seen going from the normally open contact, 98, of the overload relay to the trip indicator. This indicator light will glow if the overload relay is tripped. Please remember that both the forward and reverse contactors in the system are electrically interlocked, as demonstrated in the video. When we want to run the motor in the forward direction, we press the forward push button, causing the forward contactor to operate and its normally closed contact to open. This allows the current to flow to the motor, causing it to run in the forward direction. However, if we were to press the reverse push button while the motor is already running in the forward direction, it will not work because the dark red wire passes through the normally closed contacts of the forward contactor, which are already open. This is due to the electrical interlock between the forward and reverse contactors, which prevents both contactors from operating simultaneously. Similarly, if we want to run the motor in the reverse direction, we first press the stop push button and then press the reverse push button. This causes the reverse contactor to operate and its normally closed contact to open. However, the wire from the forward push button passes through the normally closed terminals of the reverse contactor and goes to the A2 terminal of the forward contactor. Due to this, the forward push button will not work. In summary, the electrical interlock ensures that only one contactor can operate at a time, preventing any potential damage to the motor or the system.